Hi, thanks for clicking. This is my review and analysis of Florence Foster Jenkins. The movie is about a woman who is a terrible singer but always dreams of singing at her favorite place, Carnegie Hall. It stars Meryl Streep as Florence Foster Jenkins, Hugh Grant as her husband, and Simon Helberg as her piano accompanist. Hugh Grant was fantastic. This is perhaps my favorite role that I have ever seen him in. And it's not that I haven't seen him do good work before, but this elevated him to a whole new level. I thought of him in Oscar contention for this role. That's how good he was. I completely believed that Hugh Grant's character wanted to take care of Florence and that he loved her, and he and Florence were in a very interesting position. While he was taking care of her, she was also his benefactor. That could have played out in so many different ways, but you could really feel the love that he had for her in absolutely every scene. So I just thought he did, again, an amazing job. Now, Meryl Streep, people always think she's going to do a good job, and she did, but there was nothing particularly mesmerizing or amazing about her in this movie. Period movies are generally the place where we get to see fabulous work from set decoration and costuming departments. They get to work with wonderful chenilles and laces and silks and just great fabrics and textures. And that is definitely something that we saw throughout this movie. Florence lives in a hotel apartment, and whereas it could feel stuffy and museum-like where you don't want to touch anything, instead it had a feeling of being very lived in, very comfortable, that you wanted to run your hand over all of the fabrics. You could tell that they were soft and silken. So it was just such a texturally wonderful movie that I wanted to reach out and touch absolutely everything. One of the ways that you can definitely see that the set decoration and costuming departments work together is through the motif of flowers, because flowers were absolutely everywhere in this movie. You could see them on most of Florence's clothing. If they weren't as a corsage, you could see them either embroidered or printed on the fabrics of her clothing. Hugh Grant has a tie with flowers. Wallpaper in her apartment has flowers on it. There are flowers everywhere in vases. Every single scene has flowers in it. And I think that this follows the traditional flower interpretation of meaning of life and growth and nurturing. And I think that's because Florence herself is supposed to have such a vibrant personality and be so full of life that that's what the flowers represent. Interestingly enough, though, one of the things that I learned when I was in Japan is that not all cultures see flowers the same way. So if we were going to look at this from an Eastern sensibility, the Japanese, with cherry blossoms in particular, see flowers as representing mortality because cherry blossoms have such a short blooming period. So they would see the bud as being representative of life and growth, but the flower itself is already on its way to death. So it's interesting because I don't think that's how the flowers were meant to be interpreted this go around, but I think that that interpretation can also work with the movie. So that's just an interesting way that looking at one particular motif can be interpreted in two different ways, but both of which actually work. Unfortunately, there is a lot here that didn't impress. The biggest problem is that it was just Meryl Streep going from scene to scene doing a monologue. We would hear about her character just in the exposition, just with her talking to us. There were two other really good supporting leads in this movie, and we really didn't find out very much about them at all. It was just Meryl Streep performing monologues again and again. And I think that's where the movie was lacking. I also think that this was a one-trick pony. The big joke is that Florence can't sing. We see Florence singing repeatedly in the movie, and it's supposed to be another joke. Ha ha, there she is singing again. Oh look, she's pretty terrible. I don't find it particularly funny that this woman who's going after her dream and who is working so hard is bad. It just doesn't strike me as a funny note. And another part of it is that she herself doesn't know that she's bad. She is completely insulated from criticism. When she does perform other recitals, it's only for people who are friends of hers, who already know that she's going to give their organizations a lot of money, so they want to do right by her. So they know she's terrible, but they still clap and tell her she's fantastic. That was the case with the real Florence, too. So when she performed Carnegie Hall in real life as well as in the movie, she was absolutely astounded that people were laughing and didn't think she was as wonderful as everyone around her always said she was, and how wonderful she thought she was. So I think that's a really big important distinction, because can she really be considered so brave if she had no idea that she was bad? How hard is it to do something if you think you're fabulous at it? The strength in overcoming adversity is if you think you're bad, not if you think you're amazing. She doesn't know she's bad. There are a lot of eagle-eye details to watch for. See if you can spot the two sets of Russian nesting dolls that are in Florence's apartment. They're in the big hallway entryway into her hotel apartment. Next, I mentioned the motif of flowers and how you can see flowers in every scene. See if you can spot them in particular in Simon Helberg's character's apartment. They're actually painted onto a Chinese lantern that hangs from his ceiling. Final eagle eye detail to watch for, pay attention to Florence's costume at the very beginning and at the end, because she's wearing essentially the same type of costume. The one at the end is inspired by the real Florence Foster Jenkins and one of her most famous outfits, but it's the same character of an angel, so I just thought that was a very interesting beginning and end to the movie. So have you seen Florence Foster Jenkins yet, and did you think Hugh Grant was as fabulous as I thought he was? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up button and subscribe so you don't miss my next review, and until next time, have a great week at the movies!